seats there too. Trevor, you have seats on that side as well. Yeah. Find your names. Britannia students. I'm Ariel Boulay. This is my colleague, Lynn Lay. For the past 5 years, we have been your teachers, but tonight we have the privilege of acting as masters of ceremonies for this evening's celebration of your journey to adulthood. So it is with joy that we welcome you to the 112th school leaving ceremony for Britannia Community Secondary, and for you, the graduating class of 2021.
While there will be an Indigenous welcome forthcoming, I would like to begin by acknowledging on behalf of the Britannia staff that we are on the unceded and ancestral territory of the Musqueam, Tsleil-Waututh, and Squamish nations. A photographer from Artona Studios is here, and they will be taking a picture for every graduate to have as a complimentary keepsake. And to all the parents, teachers, and community members watching this service via live stream, we welcome all of you. Following the ceremony, the graduates will be joining you outside on the lower grass field. Now, I invite you to please stand for the singing of O Canada.
Please be seated. Thank you, Ms. NT and student musicians. We now have a welcome from Morgan Garon from the Musqueam Nation, after which Ms. Suzanne Hoffman will bring her greetings from the Vancouver School Board.
Dear friends and relatives, Antisetsileno. My name is Morgan Garon. I'm a member of the Musqueam First Nation. My ancestral name is Setsileno. It's my honor to be here to share a few words with you as you embark onto the next stage of your life. These moments to our Coast Salish people, our Huamuk people, my people, the Musqueam people, are so very important. They are usually draped and honored in ceremony. The transition of your old life to your new life. And it is really indeed my honor to be here to share a few words with you today, welcoming you to this new part of your life. So we've overcome, over the last year, new changes. Changes which we thought would be temporary, but we found out very quickly weren't. But there was a good reminder of the way that the river of life flows. There are sometimes you need to paddle a little bit harder to get to where you need to go. And you honor those moments, those challenges, as they're part of you. They're part of your being and who you are as you move on to this next part of your life. So I welcome you as you step off the blanket from who you were to who you are now, this transition. Honor this moment. Be grateful for it. As you move from the beginning of your education to either your next part of your education or your next walk in life, whatever you have chosen, make it a good path because it's your path. So it's an honor to be here to share a few words with you. Love yourself on this path as well. You are loved, you are respected. And to no one else, make sure it's from yourself first. These are the teachings of my elders. On behalf of the Musqueam people, I welcome you to our traditional and unceded territory as you walk on this path. I'd like to honor my relatives from the Squamish Tsleil-Waututh as well, whose ancestors also belong to this land. Three nations, once divided by boundaries, but have always been united by bloodlines. On behalf of our people, we welcome you. Haitsepka, Haitsepka, welcome.
My name is Suzanne Hoffman, and I am the superintendent of schools. And I want to start by sincerely congratulating the graduates of 2021. I want to start by welcoming all of you to this virtual convening. And I want to welcome our parents, our families, our friends, the staff that have joined the convening, and of course, the graduates of 2021. I want to start by acknowledging the sense of loss that I think has been felt by so many of our students over the course of this year, particularly so for those that are graduating. The fact that you haven't been able to engage in clubs, extracurricular activities with your peers in a very social way, I think is a loss for all of you, and I acknowledge that this has been a year like no other. And as we go forward, I'm reminded of the things that have come about in a positive and good way. A Killarney student that I was speaking to this year spoke about school as so much more than just an educational institution. And the fact that the social nature of our world is really of paramount importance to our students. A student from Point Grey reminded me how much you've had to adapt and how much you've had to overcome. And for all of the perseverance, the diligence, the hard work that you have put into this school year, I want to recognize that. And I want to thank you for all that you have done to get to the point that you are as a graduate. Brené Brown is an author, and she speaks about life and how we transition through the phases of life. And as you think about your next phase, she talks about stepping into the arena. She talks about daring greatly and being brave. And as you look ahead in your life, I would encourage you to step into your own personal arenas. In thinking of big arenas, I think of Amanda Gorman. And she was the youngest poet laureate to ever have that title. And she stepped into an arena at the presidential election. And at that time, she shook the world. Her diminutive stature was so evident, but it was overtaken by her poise, her prose, and her presence. And she delivered such a powerful speech that was inspiring to so many. And she described herself, when we think of overcoming adversity, as someone who was a weird child. She had a speech impediment. She had an auditory processing disorder. And yet she worked to overcome the adversity and stepped into a world stage arena. Gandhi says to gently shake the world. And I would encourage each and every one of you as you contemplate the next phase of your life to go forward and make positive differences in the lives of others. Together, we can make the world a better place. And as graduates, the world lies ahead of you to make that the case for each and every one of you. I want to sincerely congratulate you on your graduation. I wish you the very best of everything in the days, the months, and the years ahead. Congratulations, graduates.
We now invite Mr. McInnes to the lectern to give the principal's address.
Thank you, Ms. Boulay. Hello, Britannia parents, families, everyone in the Britannia community, and most importantly, the Britannia class of 2021. My name is Alec McInnes, and I have the privilege of being the principal of Britannia Secondary. What a wonderful day, or I should say, what a hot and wonderful day. It is truly great to be able to acknowledge all of you as we celebrate your transition through this memorable stage of your life. I am sorry, though, that COVID-19 has taken away the opportunity to acknowledge and celebrate this as a large group with all of your family and friends. We have, however, done all we can, or all that Dr. Bonnie Henry will permit us to do, to honor you and celebrate your achievements. You have all faced the challenges of high school, embraced them, and are about to embark on the next stage of your wonderful lives. The challenges you have faced, however, were unlike any other class of Britannia graduates. Not only did you navigate your way through grades 8 to 10, as do all students, but then grade 11 came along and you were all told to stay home. Ordinarily, you might welcome being told not to go to school. However, I'm confident that you began to appreciate the importance of school, both socially and developmentally. Reflecting on the past 18 months, I tried to find one word that could sum it up. It certainly was challenging, unique, tough, remarkable, restrictive, isolating. You could even say quiet, because it certainly was around here quite a bit of the time. I would also think that some of you might have thought it was boring. However, I think that the word to use is unforgettable. The last 18 months have been unforgettable, and you, the class of 2021, for enduring everything that has been thrown at you, have been unforgettable. Thank you for your patience and persistence. Graduation is a time for gratitude. To thank those who have been involved in getting you to where you are now, your parents, your family, the incredible teachers you have had, and of course each other. I know you are thankful for those who have inspired you by believing in you and what you can do. The biggest influence on where you are now, though, has been you, your decisions, your attitude, your hard work, your judgment and behavior, your passion, drive, and motivation have all created the person that you are today. You need to keep making those decisions that have brought you to where you are now. Don't worry about making mistakes, because as Winston Churchill put it, success consists of going from failure to failure without loss of enthusiasm. And as we all know, you learn from your mistakes. I know I have. I would also advise you to continue to embrace tension. Get out of your comfort zone and try something that you're not very good at, or something that is difficult for you. Did you know that in order to move, a turtle needs to stick its neck out? There are times in your life when you have to stick your neck out and meet the challenges before you instead of hiding in a shell. Nothing ventured, nothing gained. It is important to believe in yourself regardless of the situation. Believe that you can make your goals happen. Be optimistic and keep looking for the positive. Probably most important is the need to be kind and know that kindness is contagious. Continue to develop empathy by looking for perspective, which you do when you see the world through someone else's eyes. Say thank you, and as my dad always said, try to leave things in better shape than you found them. Continue to volunteer, get involved, and make a difference. It is said that a person should be judged not so much by their accomplishments, but by their contributions. I have lots of advice for you today, as I'm sure everyone does. So let's flip the table and ask you what advice you would like to hear. What is one piece of advice as you graduate that you would like to give yourself? Think about it. Write it down in a note card and keep it. Yes, you can also put it on your phone if you'd rather, but do it and then look back on it in time. A noted journalist and author, Bill Moyers, once said, "Life is where you get your questions answered." The key point to this, though, is that you have to have questions. So I will ask you, what questions matter to you? What questions do you want to have answered? To have questions, you need to be curious. Be inquisitive, not be satisfied, and not be self-centered. It is okay if you can't think of any questions right now. And if you do, don't expect them to be answered right away either. And that's okay, because it is the journey and not the destination that is the reward. The wisdom here, though, is that life is more fulfilling when we have aspirations and challenges. All of you do have your own story, and you will continue to write it. All of you have unique talents and abilities and the potential to continue to contribute and make a difference. And you can do it. The future is bright, and there is so much in store for you. On behalf of the entire staff at Britannia Secondary, I extend to you the best wishes for everything that you so richly deserve in the years ahead. You, the unforgettable class of 2021, you have inspired us, and you believe it, and we believe in you. Thank you.
We have a third message for you from the Community Center and the 55 plus Britannia seniors. Graduating is one of those big milestones in life that already has its challenges. And this year you had the additional hurdle of a global pandemic and everything that came along with it. But despite all of this, you faced unexpected and rose to the occasion. That deserves some recognition. The Britannia 55 plus seniors and elders would like to congratulate you on this with a cedar bracelet. Woven with each strand is the well wishes for a future that is full of success, kindness, love, and laughter. Let this cedar bracelet also be a reminder for you, a reminder that you walked up a 13-year mountain, and even with that last year being a doozy, you still made it to the top.
It is now my pleasure to call Ms. Katie Simonson, grade 12 counselor, to present the Britannia Secondary School graduating class of 2021. Ms. Simonson has been working with you since grade 10. As she calls your name, you will walk up the stairs and cross the center stage to pick up your graduation package. Within your package, you will find your school leaving certificate, any awards you will be receiving, and your Britannia school pin. This special pin has been handed out to every graduate who has crossed the stage over the past century. We hope that you hold on to it as a keepsake and memory of your time here. As mentioned earlier, you will receive your official provincial graduation results in July. Now, would our first row please make their way to the stage?
Britannia would like to express a heartfelt thank you to the teachers and on our scholarship committee for the many hours of work they have put into the awards selection and presentation this evening. Thank you also to the staff members who were able to join us for this important night. At this time, we would also like to give a special thank you to the donors who enabled the school to hand out so many awards and bursaries. Britannia students also receive scholarships and awards from post-secondary institutions and other community agencies that are not a part of our normal representation. All of these scholarships and bursaries can help create financial equity that makes post-secondary school an attainable reality for many of our students. Further, several of our students have been nominated for district scholarships, and those nominees will be announced as they cross the stage.
Nguyen Nat Thi. Thi would like to thank all of the teachers in this school who guided him on his international education pathway for 2 years. All the teachers here played an important role in forming who he is, and he really appreciates it. Thank you.
During his 2 years here, Nguyen Nat Thi has shared his positivity and generosity with his teachers and peers. He is an active volunteer in the Leo's Club and in the school library, and he's a regular at the Homer Club. V has been accepted to Mohawk College in Hamilton, Ontario. He'll receive a Homer Club bursary to support him in his new city. We wish V all the best, and we hope that when the global pandemic subsides, he can be reunited with his family very quickly.
Peter Nguyen. Peter would like to thank Ms. Hong for not only being his math teacher, but for being a positive role model too, and for giving him that gentle push that allowed him to climb to new heights.
Peter plans to train as an automotive service technician. To support him in his trades education, Peter will receive an ITC Constructions Trade Scholarship and a VCC High School Entrance Award. As well, Peter is being awarded the Britannia ADST Scholarship for Culinary Arts. Peter's resilience and generosity are also being acknowledged with the awarding of the Ying Jiang Shu and Quan Chui Ying Memorial Award for students who grew up in either Stamps Place or McLean Park, and also with the William W. L. Chang Family Award, which has been funded by former graduates William Chang and Stephanie Seck. This is one of the five scholarships funded by William and Stephanie, and it's given to students who know how to pay it forward. Peter has also been nominated for a district scholarship in physical activity, and he will receive his achievement shield signifying 5 years of honor roll standing. Congratulations, Peter.
Tep Nguyen. Tep misses her family in Vietnam, but she loves Canada and is grateful for the opportunity to have new experiences and to mature. She will miss Britannia a lot.
Tep is an international student from Vietnam who has been separated from her family because of the global pandemic. However, Tep made friends with many students from Vietnam who, ironically, she would have never have met if she had not come to Canada. Tep is also a wonderfully creative jewelry designer, and she has been accepted into Kwantlen Polytechnic University, where she will study human resource management. We wish you all the best, Tep.
Tom Nguyen.
Tom is also an international student from Vietnam. He is a quiet young man, but he has a great sense of humor. In his classes, Tom worked with integrity. He was always smiling and willing to put in the time to create quality work. We wish you well for the future, and we hope you get the opportunity to see your family soon.
Kelvin Nando. Kelvin would like to thank Ms. DeForge from Strathcona, Mr. Aubuchon, and Ms. Boulay for helping him develop his art skills.
Kelvin is a passionate artist. He will be entering the workforce in order to save up money to pursue a career in the visual arts. We wish you the best of luck, Calvin, and we look forward to seeing what you create in the future. Congratulations, Calvin.
Miles Olson. Miles would like to thank, in his own words, my parents for taking care of me for the entirety of my life. Although they could not make it due to extenuating circumstances, I love them with all my heart.
Miles is Ojibwe Cree. He has been accepted to Langara to study general sciences. Miles is the recipient of the Peter McKenzie Memorial Award for Excellence, as well as the Canucks Family Education Scholarship. Both of these awards recognize students who have persevered and maintained a positive attitude in life. Miles will also receive a homework club bursary and the Walter Shinkarak Bursary. This is one of 11 bursaries that have been generously funded by Britannia alumni. Each bursary is named in honor of a former Britannia teacher and is awarded to a student with good citizenship who will be attending any post-secondary institution. Walter Shinkarak is a former Britannia alumnus and English teacher. Finally, in recognition of 5 years on the honor roll, Miles will receive his achievement shield. Congratulations, Miles.
Iftikhar Pilarka.
Iftikhar really loves cars, so it is no surprise that since completing his first year of trades training, he has just started a job at Vancouver Honda, and he hopes to obtain his red seal down the road. Iftikhar is being awarded an ITC Construction Trades Scholarship, and he is nominated for a district scholarship in trades automotive. We know you worked hard to get to this stage, Iftikhar, and we are so proud of you.
Miguel Perdomo Cashane.
Miguel played a key role on the senior boys basketball team. This year, he thrived in the Tupper Tech Studies program, and he is planning to pursue a career in auto mechanics. Miguel will be receiving the Melanie Mark Member of the Legislative Assembly Vancouver Mount Pleasant Community Leadership Award. Congratulations, Miguel.
Zoe Tobin Peterson.
Zoe is Mi'kmaq. She has amazing creative talent in drawing, writing, and jewelry design. Zoe will be taking a year off to work with the Environmental Youth Alliance. However, she plans to pursue post-secondary studies once she has saved up. To help her on this journey and to recognize her talents, she will be receiving the Adele and Dennis Case Memorial Scholarship. Adele Case was a beloved English teacher who taught for many years at Britannia. This award is given to a student who exhibits a passion for literature and writing. Zoe will also be receiving a homework club bursary and the Vancouver Secondary Teachers Association scholarship. Congratulations, Zoe.
Marcus Pelzer. In his own words, I would like to thank my mom. She is the most important person in my life, and I would not be the person I am today without her, and I'm forever grateful. I love you, Mom.
Marcus has been accepted to BCIT, where he will be studying broadcast and online journalism. Marcus would like to become a sports journalist, and he's very excited for post-secondary. He will be receiving a Britannia bursary to support his career goal.
Cielo Rivera.
Cielo loves watching animated movies and reading about animals. This year, he did travel training and he worked on improving his written work. Cielo will be moving on to the Grade 13 program at Britannia. To support him in his continued studies, he will be receiving the Developmental Disabilities Association Scholarship.
Saskia Shen Thivener. Saskia would like to thank Mr. Wong for being an encouraging IB coordinator and an engaging history teacher. He supported Saskia and helped her complete the IB diploma and get through her exams.
Saskia has been accepted to SFU, where she will begin studying anthropology. She will be receiving the Bruce Chan Scholarship. Bruce Chan is an alumnus from 1978. She will also be receiving the Vancouver Universal Buddhist Temple Award for Community Services. The recipients of this award have studied the missing chapter in Canadian history that recognizes the contribution of Chinese pioneers in British Columbia and Canada.
Powell Shi.
Anyone who has taken the time to talk to Powell knows that he has big plans to make money and get rich. He will be receiving the Homework Club bursary to start him out on that journey. Powell will also be receiving his Achievement Shield for 5 years on the honor roll. Good luck, Powell. School won't be the same without you.
Leo Stewart Smulders. Leo would like to thank his parents for all their support and wish the grads of 2021 all the best.
Leo is a multi-sport athlete who plays hockey, water polo, lacrosse, soccer, and volleyball. He has been a great leader in the Britannia Hockey Academy, and he is the alternate captain for his minor hockey team. Leo is headed to Western in Ontario, where he will pursue a degree in the social sciences. He is the recipient of both the Britannia Hockey Academy Canucks for Kids Scholarship and the Britannia Hockey Academy Graduating Scholarship. Both of these scholarships are funded by the Canucks for Kids and are presented to graduates of the Britannia Hockey Academy. Leo will also be receiving the R.H. Lee Academic and Athletic Achievement Award. Congratulations, Leo.
Hayden St. Dennis.
Hayden worked incredibly hard to make it to the graduation stage. He is an incredibly funny young man and a great athlete who loves sports. During his time at Street Front, he ran a number of marathons and half marathons. We wish you all the best, Hayden, and congratulations.
Carmen Sue. Carmen would like to thank her family, friends, and the staff. They've given her all the support she needed to get to where she is today.
Carmen has been a steady, hard worker who has never hesitated to serve the school. If you have ever spent a lunch hour in the library, chances are Carmen was at the circulation desk. She is a BD Luminary Scholar who will be studying computer science at Langara. She is receiving the Britannia ADST Scholarship in Culinary Arts, and she is also nominated for a district scholarship in ADST for Home Economics. Carmen is also being awarded a Homework Club bursary, and she will receive her Achievement Shield for 5 years on the honor roll. Congratulations, Carmen.
Alex Ta. For the record, Alex Ta can solve a Rubik's Cube in about 8 seconds.
Alex is planning to pursue a trades career in automotive technology. Throughout his high school career, Alex has been an outstanding athlete and leader in basketball and ultimate. In recognition of his accomplishments, both academic and athletic, he is receiving a series of rewards. For his participation in basketball and for his leadership on and off the court, Alex is awarded the Daniel and Mirja Pekovic Memorial Bursary and the Eric Ming Community Hero Scholarship. He has also been nominated for a district scholarship in physical activity, and he will receive the Melanie Mark Member of the Legislative Assembly Vancouver Mount Pleasant Community Leadership Award. Finally, in recognition for his athleticism, Alex is being awarded the W.R. Vance Award for Top Athlete. Mr. Vance was a legendary teacher and coach who passed away earlier this month. When he set up this scholarship, Mr. Vance insisted that the criteria for the award go beyond athleticism and include citizenship, being a good teammate, and a commitment to Britannia. We believe you fit this bill, Alex, and we know Mr. Vance would be so proud to know you have won this award. Congratulations.
Nathaniel Tafachu. Nathaniel would like to thank his mom for her continued support, and he'd like to thank the staff who helped him along the way.
Nathaniel is a gentle giant of a young man who has always had a generous smile or a kind word for the people around him. He plans to work for a while, and then he wants to become an elementary school student support worker. To help him on this path, Nathaniel will be receiving a Britannia bursary.
Jaden Terry. In his own words, I'd like to thank my mom for pushing me and helping me persevere through everything, especially when I felt like giving up.
Jaden is from the Nisga and Stadtlium Nations. He plans to play lacrosse at McGill, where he studies general arts and kinesiology. Jaden will also be receiving the Chu Family Scholarship. There were 7 Chu siblings that graduated from Britannia, and they have funded 4 scholarships to help Britannia students reach their full potential. Jaden, we wish you all the best for your move to Montreal.
Kevin Tran. Did you know that Kevin Tran can solve a Rubik's Cube in 7 seconds? He holds the record.
Kevin would like to express special thanks to Ms. Simonson for her empathy, compassion, and guidance throughout a tumultuous time in high school. Kevin has applied to SFU, where he intends to study health science. He has been nominated for a district scholarship in ADST, and he will be receiving a Homework Club bursary. Also, for his commitments to academics, Kevin is being awarded his Achievement Shield for 5 years on the honor roll.
Mason Tran.
Mason is a thoughtful and hardworking IB scholar who loves music and can solve a Rubik's Cube in 10 seconds. He has been accepted to SFU, where he will pursue a bachelor's in science. Mason is being awarded the Vancouver Universal Buddhist Temple Award, and he is also the recipient of the Doug Sue Scholarship, which is awarded to a student with good grades and a community service. Doug Sue grew up in Strathcona and Britannia communities, and at a young age, he became an orphan, and he was raised by the Boys Club of Vancouver. Doug devoted his life to service and to the community and the city that raised him. Mason will also be receiving a Homework Club bursary, and of course, he has earned his Achievement Shield for 5 years on the honor roll. Well done, Mason.
Sarah Tran.
Tran Ha Wing Lin, or Sarah, is an international student who came to Vancouver in grade 9. She is a lover of music, fashion, and friendship. Sarah plans to spend the next year focusing on upgrading before pursuing a post-secondary education. To support her future studies, she will be receiving a Homework Club bursary.
Sebastian Belgies. Sebastian would like to thank his mother, who as a solo parent has supported him and his brother and sister.
Sebastian has been accepted to the Beattie School of Business at SFU. He is extraordinarily grateful for his mentors, Mr. Chenoweth and Mr. Orr, who always had time to listen to him and show him kindness. Sebastian has been nominated for a district scholarship in ADST Business Education. Congratulations, Sebastian.
Joshua Viles. Josh would like to thank his parents and his IB teachers who have supported him in his academic journey.
Josh is an extraordinarily generous student who has quietly volunteered his time to keep the library open at lunch times for all students. He has worked incredibly hard to make it to this stage for his perseverance, commitment to service for others, and academic persistence. He is being awarded the Peter McKenzie Memorial Award of Excellence, the William W. L. Chang Family Award, and a Homework Club bursary. Congratulations, Josh.
Kevin Wang. Kevin would like to thank his mother for being there for him no matter what.
I feel almost like going off script and just handing the rest of the ceremony over to Kevin because, you know, he would take over. Through humility, hard work, and his dedication to service, Kevin has earned many well-deserved awards this evening. He is a Loran scholar who has been accepted to the University of Toronto, where he will study mathematical and physical sciences. As one of two top math students, he will be awarded the Andrew and Annis Hattrick Award. For his work as yearbook editor, Kevin will receive the Artona Studios Award, and he has been nominated for a district scholarship in fine arts. In recognition for his years of service on student council, which has included back-to-back years as school president, Kevin will be receiving both the Student Council Award and the Peter McKenzie Memorial Award of Excellence. And finally, for his superlative academic achievement, Kevin will also be awarded the Cecil White Scholarship. And it should not be a surprise that he has also earned his academic shield for 5 years on the honor roll. Kevin, congratulations.
Kitty Wang. In her own words, thank you to my mom for being supportive during tough times and for being a great role model.
Kitty has been accepted to SFU, where she will study health sciences. Throughout high school, Kitty has quietly participated in acts of service while maintaining a high academic standard. For her service to the community, she will be receiving the Britannia Community Services Center Society Scholarship and the Adele Case Bursary, named for a legendary Britannia English teacher who for the length of her career sponsored the Girls Service Club, which later became the Leo Club. In recognition of her academic studies, which have included studies of Chinese Canadian pioneers, Kitty is being awarded the Vancouver Universal Buddhist Temple Award for Community Service, and she is also receiving a Homework Club bursary. Kitty, congratulations.
Michael West.
Michael is a member of the Nisga'a Nation. He came to Britannia in grade 11, and he is ever grateful to his auntie who opened her house to him. Michael plans to upgrade for one more year before pursuing a career in trades as an electrician. Congratulations, Michael.
Dylan Wilson.
Hey, Dylan will be attending Douglas College, where she plans to pursue a career in health sciences. She is a generous and friendly person, and if you were ever lucky enough to have her as a community service student, you would know that she is funny, a quick learner, and incredibly organized. Dylan will be receiving the Britannia Elementary School Award. We wish her all the best for next year.
Madison Wolfshoe.
Madison is a member of the Siksika Nation in southern Alberta. She came to Britannia late last year, so it was pretty weird. Madison is an athlete who loves playing rugby, and she has been accepted to Langara, where she plans to study business.
Haley Wong. Haley is so happy she transferred to Britannia in grade 10. She's thankful for all the support and the opportunities she has been given.
Haley is a BD Luminary Scholar who has been accepted to UBC, where she will be pursuing a Bachelor of Commerce. For her strong academic performance, her service to the school, and her excellence on the basketball court, Haley is being awarded with a Chu Family Scholarship and a Homer Club Bursary. As well, Haley will receive the Britannia Class of 1961 bursary, which is given to a student who plans to study business or commerce.
Kara Yeh. Kara would like to thank her family, friends, and community for always supporting and encouraging her to do her best during tough times.
Kara is an outstanding service student who has served on student council and is a member of the Timers and Scores Club. Kara is also committed to the environmentalists who helped organize the district sustainability conference. In recognition of her solid academic and service achievements, as well as her embodiment of the IB learner profile, Kara will be receiving the Alan Ross Scholarship, the Tom and Phyllis Veazey Nominee Award, the Britannia Diamond Jubilee Scholarship, and the International Baccalaureate Spirit Award. Kara will also be the final recipient of the William W. L. Chang Family Award and the Vancouver Universal Buddhist Temple Award for Community Services. Kara has also been nominated for a district scholarship in international language Mandarin, and she will be receiving a Homer Club bursary and, of course, an achievement shield for 5 years on the honor roll.
Masood Youssef. Masood would like to thank Ms. Simonson, Mitra, and all the staff that facilitated his learning and helped him grow as a person.
Masood is yet another BD Luminaire Scholar. He has been accepted to UBC, where he will study engineering. Throughout his high school tenure, Masood has been outstanding in the area of service, athletics, and academics. He is this year's recipient of the Britannia Social Studies Scholarship. For his acts of service, he is being awarded the Vancouver Chinatown Lions Scholarship. Masood has run 4 full marathons, and he participated in the Street to Peak to New Zealand. In recognition of his athleticism and his leadership on the field, he is the second recipient of the W.R. Vance Award for Top Athlete. Finally, Masood will be receiving a Homework Club bursary and his Achievements Shield for 5 years on the honor roll. Congratulations, Masood.
Rebecca Zhen. Rebecca would like to thank her grade 8 and 9 counselor, Mr. Morgan, for giving her the confidence to complete her Venture IB journey.
Not only is Rebecca a multi-instrumentalist who plays flute, piano, violin, and viola, she is also a timer and scorer at the provincial level who is in the process of getting her volleyball referee's certification. When she isn't busy helping out with sports or making music, Rebecca likes to volunteer for Leo Club, Student Council, and the Villa Cathay Seniors Home. So it should come as no surprise that Rebecca is Britannia's final BD Luminary Scholar and the second recipient of the Vancouver Chinatown Lions Scholarship. For her commitment to athletics, she is being awarded the Chu Family Scholarship and the Britannia Physical Education Scholarship. Rebecca has also been nominated for a district scholarship for physical activity. And finally, Rebecca is receiving her Achievement Shield for 5 years on the honor roll. Rebecca, congratulations.
Jacob
William Brown.
William has been attending Vancouver Island University, where he plans to study recreation sports management. To support his studies, William is receiving the Britannia Alternate Education Scholarship and the Huck Pay Elementary Award.
Donovan Gladstone Lacobet.
Donovan is a true leader who continues to volunteer with and mentor StreetFront students. He plans to pursue a trades career in auto mechanics. To support his future, Donovan is being awarded an ITC Constructions Trade Scholarship.
Alexander Hunter General.
Alex is going to focus on upgrading next year. He has a great sense of humor and has been a positive and friendly peer in the outreach community.
Kane Jeffries.
Kane is friendly and approachable, and we know his sociable nature will help him as he enters the workforce following graduation.
Xavier Jeffries.
Xavier is optimistic and ambitious. We know that he is out to accomplish great things in the future.
Christina Kesewesamat.
Christina is a strong, knowledgeable woman who's finding her way onto her path of culture and healing.
Tai Louis.
Tai is a member of the Musqueam Nation. He is an aspiring artist who would like to pursue a career in design. To support his career goals, he is being awarded an ITC Construction Trade Scholarship. Congratulations, Tai.
Alicia McDonald. Alicia would like to thank Gord, Barry, and Trevor.
Alicia is a phenomenal woman. In grade 8, she was the youngest student to participate in Street to Peak on their trek to Patagonia. She has cared for her siblings and been in the workforce since the age of 15. She has worked incredibly hard to earn her dogwood and to keep her family together. In acknowledgement of her resilience and grit, Alicia will be receiving the Steve Lott Memorial Bursary. Congratulations, Alicia.
Emily Nelson. Emily would like to thank her family, friends, and teachers for supporting her and pushing her through school.
Emily is a determined student with a creative mind. She would like to pursue a career as either an art teacher, or an aesthetician. She will be entering the workforce to save towards her post-secondary education. In recognition of her perseverance and hard work, Emily will be receiving a Britannia bursary. Congratulations, Emily.
John Sparrow.
John is a positive, friendly, curious young man who has a great outlook on life. He plans to enter the workforce and then apply to post-secondary school in the future. To support him on this journey, he will be receiving a Britannia bursary. Congratulations, John.
Kasia Warrior.
Kasia is from the Piikani Nation in Alberta. She has worked very hard to cross the stage today. Following graduation, she will be looking for work, but her long-term goal is to become an education assistant. Kasia will be receiving a Britannia bursary to support her future endeavors. Congratulations, Kasia.
Maximus Wildman Raymond.
Max is one of those students who brings joy to the classroom. He is positive, helpful, kind, and as funny as they come. He is a tremendous athlete who has run 4 full and 4 half marathons. He also trekked to New Zealand with the Street to Peak team. Max worked incredibly hard to make it to this stage, and in recognition of his resilience and perseverance, he will be receiving the Lenny and Walter Eng family bursary. Congratulations.
Aisha Rose Yuxel.
Aisha is our final graduate to cross the stage today. Aisha is a mature, resilient, and independent young woman. She will be upgrading in the fall. We want to congratulate her on completing her high school journey and wish her all the best in her continued studies. Congratulations. I would like to thank Spirit Lavallee and Jim McLean, teachers at Outreach, and to Ms. Simonson for announcing our graduates. We now invite Ms. Katie Simonson, back to the podium to give the counselor's formal address to the graduates.
Okay, so the time has finally arrived. This surreal last month of high school, this final week of reflection and excitement, and this grand day full of celebration on your behalf. Whether these last few years felt like a cakewalk, whether it took all your strength and vigor to get it done, or whether a carrying staff member dragged you across the finish line, you are here closing this chapter, and that's a really big deal. People tend to say to teachers in June, oh, you must be so excited, the summer is almost here. And I found myself this year thinking, yes, of course, always, but I'm really in no rush. I want to have time to soak up and enjoy the little things so that I can remember you all just how you are right now in this moment in time. And I encourage you to do the same. Amongst the busyness of these last few days of a time in your lives that will never come again, to remain in the moment, to not flip the page just yet. Try to be right here, right now, right in the center of it all, because today is the oldest you've ever been. It's the youngest you'll ever be again, and after this, everything changes. Whatever your feelings about Britannia, whether it's terrifying to say goodbye to the familiarity, or you're bursting at the seams, ready to move on to the next chapter, I promise you that this change is good, and you are ready for it. I have had the great privilege of sitting with many of you this last school year, while you shared past stories of regret and triumph, and expressed both fears and anticipation for the future. And my advice was always to be kind to yourself and recognize that this is a journey. Your life is a story that has never been told, and what a tremendous gift that is. To know that this next chapter is completely unwritten, and only you get to tell the story, create the setting, choose the characters, and live it out. Sometimes high school feels like a static experience, and you merely survive it. You don't really get to have much of a say in how it plays out. I have every confidence that this next chapter or part of the story is unique, it's beyond worthy of comparison, and it deserves to be told. But along with this great narrative are plot twists, changes that happen to you rather than ones you choose for yourself. And my greatest hope is that you will be graceful and free yourself of that which is not meant for you, and let go of the idea that it could have ever been any different. Many of you will not graduate university in 4 years. Many of you will not graduate at all or even go to school, and that's totally okay. You'll experience a myriad of great heartache and loss and be forced to rewrite sections of your story that you were so confident would be part of everything. For some of you, the expectation to discover inner strength, to be resilient and trudge through the thickness of pain has already been part of many chapters, while others will experience it anew. Wrestle with it, grieve it, sit in the discomfort, in the vulnerable moments, and then grow from it. Let it be a catalyst for the next great discovery of who you are becoming and all the bits and pieces that make up your extraordinary lives. And so my final parting invitation for each of you, after offering congratulations and a little bit of comfort that it is going to be okay, is to place upon you a challenge. I ask that each and every one of you take an active role in your own lives. begin to consider that crazy and ridiculous and hard and complicated things happen for you, not to you, for you to be bigger and bolder and far wiser. I have every confidence that each of you can take on this challenge and make it your own. Hard work, success, and growth will look different for each and every one of you. You actually don't get to write someone else's story and call it your own, and you also don't get to hand yours off to someone and have them write it for you. Take an active role in your own lives, the life that is spread out before you, the one that can hardly wait to see what you'll do next. Know that you are deserving of goodness and write that on every page that you can. It has been the greatest honor of my early career to walk alongside you. I will so miss the familiarity that comes with seeing each of you in the hallways of this school every day, or at least when you are willing to show up. This last month, thank you, pal. This last month has been incredibly bittersweet because selfishly I don't want to let you go, but I know that you are ready for something more. I feel a tremendous sense of pride and admiration and respect for the kind, funny, and wonderful young people you are becoming and continue to become. Please know that your place as a Britannia Bruin lives on long after you have graduated. You will stay dear to our hearts, clear in our minds, and deep in our thoughts. Now it's time to go off and do incredible things with your story. I wish you nothing but the very best in writing this next exciting chapter. And so now I want to make way for the man, the myth, the legend that is your valedictorian, Mohammed El-Sarraji. So Mo was born and raised in this community, and after moving to Britannia in grade 10, he quickly made a name for himself as one of the most charismatic and friendly and hardworking students at our school. So here are a couple things I know to be true about Mo. He loves Tommy Wiseau's 2003 movie, The Room, almost as much as he loves science. He draws endless inspiration from Simba and Kermit the Frog. His physical height is 5'8", but spiritually he's about 7'6". And few things get him more excited than Taylor Swift's song 22 and the Soviet Union national anthem, of course. Mohammed was one of 100 students chosen as a Schulich Award recipient out of 300,000 applicants. This scholarship is considered the most prestigious STEM award in Canada, so it's kind of a big deal. After participating in a science fair in grade 8 and receiving some feedback that he couldn't let go to waste, his personal journey of discovery really began. Mo described to me that science is like an art form. There are no constraints. You can break things down, build them up, and the ability to do so never really ends. The trial and error process has proven to be self-motivating, along with the euphoria he experiences when something finally works. He is a friend to all, a mentor to many, and someone who will be dearly missed at Britannia. I ask you all to welcome with great warmth to the stage your valedictorian for the class of 2021, Mohammed El-Sarraji.
Hey, yo, what's crack clacking? It's your boy Mo. Thank you, Ms. Simonson, for that absolutely awesome intro. Before I start, I'd like to first acknowledge that we work, live, and play on the traditional, ancestral, and unceded territories of the Musqueam, Squamish, and Tsleil-Waututh Coast Salish peoples. After what seemed to be like the longest spring break we've ever had last year, after countless online classes, after awkwardly unmuted conversations, and after one too many visits from the fire department, we made it. Comrades, let us share in the success. Finally, we can tell our children that we lived through a pandemic and that they have no excuse not to go to school. Where I'm from, we call that a power move. It feels so surreal to me that every challenge, stepping stone, and experience these last few years has culminated to become what it is right now. It feels like just yesterday we were so unprepared for high school, so unprepared to write in the active voice, and so unprepared to call recess our break between classes. But look at us now. When things felt like they were falling apart, we still managed to come to class, pursue the hobbies and sports we love, and challenge the odds of this pandemic. If this last year was my cousin's 10th birthday party, then we were the gosh darn pinata, baby. But yet, we're still here to tell the tale. IB students, despite the weight of lost teaching time, still pulled through, still finished their exams, and have now started to catch up on the months of sleep they've obviously lost. Two students even thought it would be a good idea to take HL Math, as though IB wasn't hard enough already. At Lucas and Reese, y'all are built different. I once learned from communist dictator Vladimir Lenin that peace, land, and bread are all any stable population needs to stay afloat. I'm sure I speak for most of us when I say we're finally at peace, and I'm sure bread isn't going to be scarce anytime soon. That leaves land unacquired, so my fellow graduates, it is time we divide and conquer. Today is the day we finally coast off our nest eggs to do that. However, friends, we stand here today with the help of a few important people. People like our parents who put up with us these last few years, and teachers and support staff who have been our lifeline for just as long. This final year has been especially difficult, so with the limited time I have, I wanted to honor them. To our language department, for teaching what is arguably the hardest thing to teach, and for doing so despite the onset of this pandemic. To our social studies and history department for showing us what it meant to be alive in the last century. You can call it Lebensraum because the knowledge now lives in our headspace rent-free. To our Department of Applied Design, Skills, and Technology for the comfort and creative leniency they provided for so many students in need of it. To our Department of Physical Education for giving us a fun-filled break when most of our other classes didn't. To our math department for teaching us that math is so much more than letters and numbers. While some think of Isaac Newton as the godfather of calculus, you won't really know how to do it until you enter Mr. Lay's classroom. Khan Academy, more like twitch.tv/laycalcul. To the science department, who owes some of the most patient human beings you'll ever meet, but who also made us sweat both figuratively and literally. Admittedly, we went to class in the ground state, but always left with a positive charge. Shout out to Ms. Ganatra for teaching me that you don't need sleep to be an excellent teacher and parent. To our English department for introducing us to the vast expanse of literature and books that, you know, I still try and reread because they were that good. Thank you, Ms. Les, for teaching me some of the coolest literary techniques I'll ever know. Some of these techniques include, but of course are not limited to, enjambments, iambic pentameter, and extended metaphors. You best believe I'll be using these at parties. To the committed and hardworking staff in the alternative programs, thank you for having faith that all kids can make it. To our counseling staff for making school feel like a second home, and to Ms. Simonson specifically for doing the absolute most as our counselor this last year. To Lena, Deneen, and Philippa down at the cafeteria for making sure school lunch always slapped. To Ms. Sherman specifically for helping us peel through every possible layer of abstraction during TOK, hashtag stay woke. To Ms. Sarah Ng, for letting myself and so many stressed students study in the library even when she had a class and we technically shouldn't have been inside. To both Mitra and Stokes, who are amongst the most prominent advocates for youth involvement and shape the backbone to our school and community center. And lastly, to Mr. Wong, who single-handedly juggled an English class and a history class, all while being IB coordinator. As IB students, Mr. Wong was there for us at our darkest hour. I'm also convinced that he is a modern-day Superman. Coordinator Wong by day, the amazing Hubert by night. My friends, I can't wait to see where life takes each and every one of us. In a few years' time, some of you may be engineers and some of you may be carpenters. Some of you may travel the world and some of you may still be hammering away at school. But through it all, I really hope that at least one of you becomes the next Lil on SoundCloud. That'd be really cool. Whatever the case, there's no doubt in my mind that we will excel at whatever we choose to do in the future. But through it all, I urge you to remember a few things that I always forget when I'm in limbo between what is and what can be. Jamie Smith, or Mr. Smith, has always reinforced in the 15 years that I've known him that life isn't always going to be linear. We leave high school learning that some of the best essays are those that are first iterated as flowcharts, as an organized series of causes and effects. But reading Jamie Smith's essay, I realized that this couldn't be any further from the truth. Jamie has upended the rigidity I was trying to implement in my life after high school. Being a hockey coach, PE teacher, day camp leader, and above all else, a member of this community, Jamie has taught me that life isn't systematic and predictable, and in fact, shouldn't be treated as though it were. Every day during the summer I volunteered with Jamie, he said, in his most prophetic voice and with a reassuring stroke of his beard, that if it isn't your first, it could be your last, and that life is too easy because sometimes we complicate it for no reason. Instead of bashing his head against the wall when he lost his two front teeth playing hockey, he embraced the look, insisting that it made him seem meaner and that his mom still thinks he's cute. To this day, he continues to swivel on ice with grace and a sort of poetry in motion that I try to adopt as I learn to live in the moment a bit more. So as a testament to what Jamie taught me, I pass this on to you. Understand that it's okay if you don't know what your next step is from here. I learned from friends and experiences that academia can sometimes seem like a bureaucracy, an echo chamber where the same tenets are repeated over and over again. Whatever choices you make, ensure that they're reflective of your values and don't conform to become something you're not. To those of you intending to pursue higher education, seek for success, but don't let any hunt for a 4.0 GPA obscure the more subtle pleasures in life. While Jamie taught me that dreams only work if you do, he also taught me that one must chase their morals before they chase the bag, to never get lost in the sauce, and that above all else, it's okay to take it easy. My friends, this is the first day of the rest of our lives. Be excited, be hopeful, and don't let fear of the unknown take too much away from that. A wise Britannia alum by the name of Joel Never Skip Leg Day Rossi once asked me, in an hour of solace that many IB students experience, "Hey Momo, why do we fall?" Taken back by the question, I was unable to respond, so Joel answered for me, "Momo, we fall in order to learn how to get back up." As a former Britannia alum who's faced hardship head-on, an alum who slayed a couple intimidating dragons in his day, and an alum who's confronted his fears growing up in this community, I hold solemnly to my heart Rossi's words and see them as far more than passing rhetoric. So, graduates of 2021, I'll end by urging you to persevere in your moments of hardship, to take your time, and to continue your legacy as Britannia Bruins. With that being said, it's been your boy Mo. Thank you for the memories, thank you for the laughs, and thank you for the school lunch. Wasabi.
Thank you, Mo. Mo received the valedictorian award in the last ceremony, so congratulations again, Mo, for a job well done. I'm gonna turn the page on. Okay. Academic achievement medals. Britannia also recognizes the outstanding achievement of the top students in the graduating class by awarding the bronze, silver, and gold medals to those students ranking third, second, and first, respectively. The silver medal academic scholar is a friendly, unassuming young man, a marathon runner, as well as a much-loved leader at the Britannia Fun Seekers Day Camp program. He served on this year's student council, and he is an outstanding IB student. Congratulations, Mohammed. You are this year's academic silver medal recipient. Our gold medal recipient is a humble hard worker. He is a multi-instrumentalist, and he has also volunteered for the Fun Seekers Day Camp program. He is the first student in over a quarter century, and possibly the only student, to serve as school president for two consecutive years. Would you please welcome Kevin Wang, the academic gold medal recipient, to the stage. Kevin, would you please stay on the stage? Mr. McInnes is going to award the next award.
The Hall Watts Award was originally named for Britannia's first two principals. In 2016, a third name was added to the award to honor Bob Fitzpatrick, a long-serving teacher at the school. The Fitzpatrick Hall Watts Award is Britannia's most prestigious prize, and the winner is the equivalent of a Rhodes Scholar. The candidate must be outstanding in academics and service, as well as athletics and/or arts. The candidates should be a good person who makes a positive difference to the life of Britannia. The Fitzpatrick Hall Watts has only been handed out 11 times in the past 30 years, and there was no winner last year. This year, it is our pleasure to acknowledge the commitment Kevin has shown to the Britannia community. His service record is impressive, to say the least. He has been an active member of the school badminton team, and he is a talented musician who is always generous with sharing his gifts with others. Kevin, congratulations. You are the first Fitzpatrick Hall Watts winner of the 2020s.
Stay on the stage, Kevin. And finally, the Governor General of Canada offers a medal to the top graduating student who has achieved the top grade point average. Of course, that means that this year's winner is you, Kevin Wang. Okay, you'll see it in August. And lastly, we have three more graduates to recognize. Every year, we must say farewell to retiring colleagues and thank them for their service to our community and to public education. This year, we recognize Michelle Ray, Matt Hives, and Elizabeth Holmes. Michelle Ray worked in the Britannia office for 10 years. In her role as office assistant, she was at the front line communicating with parents, children, and staff. Michelle now has the time to spend with her grandkids, and we would like to wish her all the best. Matt Hives, he has worked as a special education assistant for over 30 years. He spent the bulk of his career at Strathcona and then at King George Secondary. The grade 13 program was very lucky to have Matt join the classroom for his final years as a student support worker. Matt loves being out in the community supporting the students, rain or shine. He could also have a side gig teaching cooking, as he and the students love his weekly Cooking with Matt sessions. Matt, thank you for your service, and we hope you get enough time off to enjoy music, cycling, and all the other things that bring you joy. And lastly, Elizabeth Holmes. What can you say about Lizzie Holmes? Liz spent 25 years as the head administrative assistant in the Britannia office, but she was so much more. Ask any substitute teacher what they remember about Britannia, and they will always mention Liz's smile, her joyful welcome, and her grace. We were lucky enough to work with Elizabeth Holmes, and she has earned a well-deserved retirement. Yeah, Elizabeth Holmes in the back. Once again, congratulations to all of the retirees. We wish all of you an excess of free time to do whatever you want. Now, before we end the ceremony, we have a special tribute to Bill Vance, a legendary Britannia teacher who passed away on June 11th of this year. Sarah Ng, please come forward.
Good evening, students. It is such a pleasure to stand up here with other Britannia Bruins. Mr. Vance started his teaching career at Strathcona Elementary. In 1966, he came to Britannia where he worked as a physical education teacher until his retirement in 1996. To say that Mr. Vance loved Britannia and that he was well loved by his students is an understatement. He was cut from a different cloth, and he poured his life into this school. He put Britannia on the map for football and wrestling, in which he led numerous teams to provincial championships. In 2016, he was honored by the BC Lions with an Orange Helmet Award in recognition of his contribution to amateur football in our province. By the time I was a student at Britannia, Mr. Vance was known for dominating high school wrestling. But he always knew that it was about much more than sports, and that's why the criteria for the Athlete of the Year scholarship includes citizenship, commitment to the school, and being a good teammate. Mr. Vance taught my father and my uncle, and he coached both of my brothers. He had a way of turning ordinary young men into champions, regardless of whether they were on his teams or not. Mr. Bill Vance was a Britannia legend who deserves to be remembered. His dedication and commitment to his profession and this school is the gold standard, which all of us, teachers and students alike, should strive to attain. I know Mr. Vance would have been filled with so much joy to see you all here today, and I know that he's sending you all the good wishes for the future. Thank you.
This evening's ceremonies represent many months of hard work and dedication by numerous staff and students. I would like to take a moment on behalf of everyone here this evening to thank those involved. Oh, no wonder. Specifically, I want to express gratitude to Ms. Yolanda Eng and the Scholarship Committee, Ms. Katie Simonson and the Graduation Committee, and Ms. Janet Griffiths in the office. I would also like to thank the many volunteers and the many faculty who are here this evening.
And we would also like to thank Sports Canada TV and Choyal for the live stream. Yes.
Okay, and now the moment you have all been waiting for, graduates of 2021. Would you please stand and turn and face the cameras? Waiting outside are your family and friends who have supported you on this journey. To the parents and guardians who have walked with your children to this place, we thank you. Grads, take this moment to give a round of applause for the people who have supported you on this path. And now we present to you the graduating class of 2021. Ta-da! Woo! Graduates, your people are waiting for you outside. This part of the journey is done. There is a bit of an order to leading everyone out, so would everyone please sit down again? Ms. Knobs Thiessen is going to cue some music to walk out with, and Ms. Les, or Mr. Stokes, would you please lead the graduates from the auditorium to go and greet your families? Congratulations, everyone. Well done.